New on Curiosity Stream. She was a loving wife, a devoted mother. She also stole atomic secrets and gave them to the Soviets. Meet the woman whose deception kick-started the Cold War on The Spy Who Stole the Atom Bomb. And...
what if they catch you?
Then I shall be shot.
They're coming! Come back!
Relive history's most death-defying escapes. It's Impossible Escapes, Civil War. Watch now on Curiosity Stream. Annual plans are $20, just $1.67 a month. Visit curiositystream.com.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. When we think about the COVID-19 vaccine hesitancy in the Black community, let's remember, it didn't happen by chance. It's justified in history. But the will to change the narrative is strong today, and our people are lending their voices to the conversation. We're sharing our stories and the reasons that made us choose the vaccine so we can lead the way for others to make a well-informed choice, too. To hear our stories, visit hearforuswa.org.
What's up? It's your boy, the Fed Smith. Thanks for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast. Want more? Check out the greatest podcast in all the land, The Podcast. Be sure to subscribe and listen to a brand new episode every Tuesday night.
Somebody out there deserves to be recognized. And the Men's Room knows just who it is. So to you, we say, bottoms up, sailor. You're the toast of our shot of the day.
Drink time it is, and as usual, we head to the drink desk and Steve at Thrill Hill to find out who we're toasting.
Yes, indeed, and today we toast Avcare. Avcare, by the way, it's a pharmaceutical distributor headquartered in Tennessee. Now, Avcare, they're the distributor of Slidenafil. Do you know what Slidenafil is?
Drug?
It is a drug, but specifically, it is the active ingredient in Viagra. And by the active ingredient, we mean the part of Viagra that replaces your erectile dysfunction with an actual erection. Now, Avcare also distributes Trazodone. And Trazodone, that's used to help treat depression and anxiety. Well, earlier today, Avcare issued a recall on a specific lot of Slidenafil and a certain lot of Trazodone. Now, there's actually nothing wrong with either drug. In fact, both work perfectly fine, and that's part of the problem, because you see, thanks to what they're saying is a third-party bottler, the Slidenafil and the Trazodone were accidentally packaged together.
Ooh.
So you open this bottle, the pills look the same, one might give you an erection, the other one reduces your anxiety. So if you're depressed and you pop a pill, you might get an erection. If you're hoping to get an erection, you might not, but you won't be depressed about the fact that you didn't.
I bet both of these placebos work.
That's the funny part. The terrifying part are the side effects of each drug that you might not be prepared for. So, again, depending on your medical condition, the Slidenafil, that's plummeting blood pressure. Right? Think about that. So if you're already someone who has high blood pressure and you're already taking medications for that, if you take this, it's going to get severely worse. And then you also have blurred vision, dizziness, and my favorite, constipation if you take the Trazodone.
Damn.
And again, side effects are side effects, but when you don't know the side effects are just awful.
Let's get a contestant online for profile. This will take caller 9 at 206-421-ROCK.
Yeah, so the problem was both drugs work perfectly fine. They work as intended. This third-party bottler, unfortunately, put them all kind of in one jar and then shipped this out to different places.
Yeah, I mean, look, so, in theory, if you don't have a heart condition or something, then yeah, you're going to be chilled out with a rager.
If you don't.
And, and your depression will be gone.
Right, that's what I'm saying. But I...
do you know if you have a heart condition? See, that's part of the problem.
Right, like, I saw a movie where there was a scene where a girl, like, they went back to her house after the club, and he was having a little trouble.
Right.
She crushed up about her, and then he gets taken out of a stretcher because he has a heart condition.
Right. So I don't know if I have a heart condition. Now, the last time I went to the doctor, I did not.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know what's happening. But you pop one of these things because, man, I've been feeling depressed. I'm really anxious. Like, I have an erection that won't go away.
Yeah.
Or I'm trying to get an erection. I don't have an erection, but I don't care.
No. I feel great.
You. Yeah. So either way, yeah, you might want to check in that recall if you take either one of those drugs. In the meantime, let's drink. We pour this booze, and we drink this booze because we think it's yummy.
Yummy!
So over the tongue and down the throat to party in our tummies. Down the hola, bitchola!
The Men's Room presents Profile This.
And Steve the Thrill Hill, could you please tell everyone how Profile This is played?
Well, I sure can, Miles. It's a simple game where we share with you a real-life news story, something that happened right here on planet Earth. And as you listen to the story, based on the stereotypes you believe to be true of people and the decisions that people make, we will ask you what it is you think makes the story a story. Damn it. Oh, my bad. Hello, Candy. Welcome to the men's room.
Candy.
Hello.
Hola.
It's just like Hola. Candy.
All right, Candy, you understand how this year's game is played?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Then you know you have a choice of one of three stories. We have the wonderful world of drugs. We have bites me. In other words, what did someone find in their food? And finally, interior decorating, where you guess the foreign objects that ended up on the inside of someone.
Ooh, I like bite me.
You like bite me?
Bite me. Sweet, Candy.
All right.
Bite me. Yeah.
Oh. All right, Candy.
Yeah.
All right, Candy. Here is your story.
Okay.
A man found something unusual packed inside of a pint of frozen custard that he bought from a Kohl's frozen custard shop. And officials, well, they believe they've been able to trace the source. Now, the customer, one Clarence Stowers, said he put the object in his mouth thinking it was a piece of candy when he opened the pint at home. He said, quote, "I thought it was candy. Ha ha, what do you know? I thought it was candy because they put candy in your ice cream to make it a treat. I said, oh my God, this ain't no nut. So I came in here to the kitchen and rinsed it off with water and realized what it was, and I just started screaming." Well, the representative from the State Agriculture Department's Food and Drug Division said state officials closed the shop while the food processing equipment involved was cleaned and sanitized. Now, Candy, he was expecting to get a bite of you, per his thing, a piece of candy. But it was not you. What was it? Was it a mouse head, a roach, a severed finger, or a Band-Aid? So mouse head, roach, a severed finger, or Band-Aid. That's what he found in his custard instead of finding you.
Mouse head, well, roach, finger,
or Band-Aid.
You always hear about the severed finger. But I'm going with that mouse head. That sounds tasty.
Mouse head for candy. You really think that's what it is?
I do. I think the mouse head. Ugh.
I'm sure mouse head is tasty. One of the chefs I worked for, and I've always remembered this, I don't remember what he made, but he wanted all of us to try it.
Mm-hmm.
I tried some. He looked at me, said, "What do you think?" I said, "That's tasty." And his exact quote to me was, "Hey, dog ass is tasty. Is this good or bad?"
Okay, I'm gonna take roach out of the equation. Because I don't think he would have dropped to his knees and screamed and all that.
It was in his mouth, mom.
I know, but people eat roaches.
Who? Not in America.
Well, I know, but I mean, it is.
You ever seen how people react to a roach?
Yes, I know. It's pretty disgusting.
I mean, even on the floor, it's like, you must die.
But as much as Candy's going to go all in with mouse head, I think I'm going to go all in with finger, Ted.
Where was the ice cream, or the, sorry, it was a custard, right? So was it from Jersey?
Someone plates called, you know what, I don't know where this is. Hold on.
But the great thing about it is the guy's name. He is the guy that would order a custard. What was his name again?
Clarence Stowers.
Yeah, exactly. Clarence, what do you want? Custard.
Somewhere on the East Coast, I only know this because one of the news outlets he spoke to begins with a W, but I'm not sure where.
Okay.
Right, I feel like custard's a much bigger deal on the East Coast than
sure.
It is out here on the West Coast. Where's it more ice cream and gelato?
Plenty of roaches
Italian,
over there.
Which is Italian for ice cream.
And it wasn't that disappointing. Like torta,
yeah.
Spanish for sandwich.
I know. But I found out what gelato, I thought I was like, gelato is like fancy ice cream. And then I found out, and I said, "I knew you was lying to me, woman. I don't know why we have to get this expensive ass stuff.
If it's gelato, it costs more. That's all."
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
We got to give it some fancy name. Give me the vanilla ice cream. You know what I'm ordering. All right. I'm getting off track here. I love gelato. It's very Italian to me, because the East Coast got a lot of Italians. You know what? I want it to be a finger. Because I'm into this
you
whole
want
drug.
It to be? Okay.
Well, I'm into this whole drug cartel running thing, and I like the idea that somebody messed up, so I chopped off his finger.
All right.
And it ended up there. But Miles was so confident that it can't be a roach. I'm going roach.
You're going roach, and Candy, you're going to stay with mouse head, right?
I'm staying with mouse.
What did he bite into that was in the custard? Was it a mouse head, a roach, a finger, or a Band-Aid? We'll let you know next.
That was a tease.
New on Curiosity Stream.
Just because it hasn't been done before doesn't mean you can't.
Watch Earth's greatest minds forge our path to a better tomorrow. It's Engineering the Future and Jaws, Star Wars, The Godfather, E.T. The biggest movies have even bigger music. From King Kong to The Dark Knight.
See how musicians scored Hollywood's greatest hits on great film composers' music of the movies. Watch now on CuriosityStream. Annual plans are $20, just $1.67 a month. Visit CuriosityStream.com.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. When we think about the COVID-19 vaccine hesitancy in the Black community, let's remember, it didn't happen by chance. It's justified in history. But the will to change the narrative is strong today, and our people are lending their voices to the conversation. We're sharing our stories and the reasons that made us choose the vaccine so we can lead the way for others to make a well-informed choice, too. To hear our stories, visit hearforuswa.org.
Well, great balls of fire, Bubba.
What happened, Buford?
That crazy son of a Sal blew right through that four-way stop of Main Street and plowed into my cowboy Cadillac.
Your what?
My pickup truck. And I'm pretty sure my leg is broken, Ted.
Oh, quit your bitching, Buford, and talk with those side busters at the Advocates Law Firm. When I got busted up last month, well, shoot, they made sure those snakes at the insurance company played fair.
Boy, howdy. Even that creepy so-and-so Kyle earned his keep.
So if you get injured, the advocates get results. AdvocatesLaw.com.
The shenanigans continue. This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
All right, we got some work to do here if we're going to be BJ and Megs. Please donate now for Coats for Kids, KISW.com. We need the rich people to step up. In the meantime, yeah, because they did a hell of a job this morning, man. And look, it all goes to a great cause. Either way, we all win.
Right.
We just wanted to beat BJ and Migs.
Bragging rights, you know.
That's all. Then we walked in the hallway, we can go like we did before. Not tomorrow if we don't get that money. KISW.com. Codes for Kids Day is presented, by the way, by our friends at The Advocates. Okay, we'll profile this today. The subject was Bite Me, category-wise. And a guy named Clarence decided to get himself some frozen custard, and he thought that maybe what he was biting into was like a piece of candy or something that they added into the, you know. But no, this has not been a Jerry's. Then he rinsed it off and looked at, and actually could identify the object.
Yes.
And that object could have been a mouse head, a roach, a finger, or a Band-Aid. But keep in mind, state officials went in and closed the plant and the shop based on what he found in the custard.
Yes, indeed. And Candy, we asked you, did you think it was a mouse head, roach, severed finger, or Band-Aid? And in spite of your delicious name, you went with a mouse head.
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry, Candy.
That does give me some relief.
Would you pick Miles?
I picked a finger, Ted.
Finger.
Ted, you picked a roach.
Damn it.
And then Miles, you picked a severed finger.
Yes!
Oh!
Yes!
Now wait, here's the crazy thing. So the custard shop owner, one Craig Thomas, he told a local TV station there that a 23-year-old employee who lost the finger had dropped a bucket while working with the machine that dispenses the custard. He tried to catch the bucket when the accident occurred. So even though he admits he knew that the guy chopped off his finger, he knew it fell in the bucket, and he knew that the bucket went to the custard, he still sold the batch of custard anyway. Here's the really effed up part. At the same shop last summer, a different employee lost part of their finger in one of the machines.
Damn. What is going on at this shop?
Who knew the custard game was so dangerous?
It was two fingers in a year and a half, man. You got to do something.
That's not happening at Rita's.
No.
Also, by the way, because it is December, do you know what that story with Clarence has to do with December?
I don't know.
It was The Name of the Angel, and It's a Wonderful Life.
You know what? You're right. It was.
All comes back around.
It all comes back.
Throw that's for you, bud.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Now for all TV news all the time, it's time for TV Time with Ted.
And now, because your pathetic life is confined to countless hours in front of a talking box, the Men's Room presents TV Time with Ted.
Ah! All right, your choices today, the Jimmys.
Jimmy Kimmel, Jimmy Fallon.
Seth Meyers.
Seth is on the list.
Conan O'Brien.
Okay.
Or Ted Smith.
Is it Ted or is it late?
That's it. All these guys have a team of professional writers that help them come up with their monologues each and every night. It is up to you to determine, is this an actual late night joke and from whom? Or could it be a V. Ted Smith original?
Have you guys saw this? But a man in Italy took a walk for 7 days to get out of the house after an argument with his wife and was only found when police located him for violating COVID protocol. Or reached for comment, he said, quote, just tell me what you want to eat.
Be sensitive. Yeah.
Yeah, that is fake. I mean, I'm willing to bet that was the argument.
But court, you know,
what's for dinner?
What's for dinner? We're going to do this again?
I don't want Italian. We live in Italy.
But you keep saying that you don't care, but you do care.
Yes. Funny. Do you ever say you're going out for American if you just go to like a bar and get a burger?
No.
Then you're just going to get bar food.
Yeah. That's weird.
But American food is bar food in my mind.
Right. And on delivery services, they call it American.
Sure.
But I've never thought like, yeah, I'm going to go get American tonight.
Right. Well,
like
when I was in Italy, if they had American food, they were real clear about it. Like, American food.
What were the native original mozzarella sticks like in Italy?
Oh, my God. You've never had anything like it.
They're fantastic.
Truly
they're
from the motherland.
Yeah.
They're like mozzarella. What?
In Russia, they're telling people not to drink alcohol for 2 months after taking the Russian vaccine.
I'm sorry. I thought that was a joke.
Russians heard this and said, eh. We take chances with virus. I want more Italian there.
I'll go Fallon.
That's Jimmy Fallon.
Well, some news from overseas. In Russia, they're telling people not to drink alcohol for almost 2 months after taking the Russian vaccine. Russians heard and were like, we'll take our chances with the virus.
Excuse me.
Nice.
You know, Mike, I can still taste the, what was that one just called that I drank?
I believe you had, doggone it. Hang on, I had it here.
All right.
Somewhere. You still have the taste in your mouth?
Well, it's the hot sauce.
And the marinara.
Oh, you had the game day blend,
the game day and the Frank's Red Hot. Frank's Red Hot.
You're keeping it down, though.
Yeah. Joe Exotic, also known as the Tag King. I just like to say stuff. Joe Exotic, also known as the Tire King, is trying to get himself a presidential pardon, and his plan to get out is no other than Kim Kardashian. He wrote her a handwritten personal plea. Imagine if the Kardashians get OJ and Tiger King off the hook.
God, I hope that's you, Ted.
Conan O'Brien.
Jimmy Kimmel.
Miles, good call. That's Jimmy Kimmel.
Joe Exotic, also known as the Tiger King, is trying to get himself a presidential pardon, and his plan to get out is none other than Kim Kardashian. He wrote a handwritten personal plea. Imagine if the Kardashian family got the Tiger King and OJ off the hook. I mean...
according to a new study, sports can be a good form of therapy for boys with behavioral problems. Another good option? Therapy.
Seth, mom.
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, that's...
According to a new study, sports can be a good form of therapy for boys with behavioral problems. Another good option? Therapy.
Which is kind of crazy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know that I've ever... I don't know if I've ever thought about, like, behavioral problems when it comes to watching kids play sports.
Not much.
I mean, right, because you're out doing stuff. I'm sure there was some kid, I don't know, doesn't everybody have a behavioral problem?
Everybody does, even if they don't think they do.
Yeah, that's what I tell the ladies.
Oh, no.
Breaking news.
Are we, we're $2,000 off, Mike?
Correct.
All right, Coats for Kids Day, KISW.com. We are trucking along, man. We've got a little bit of time here, half an hour to get this bad boy done. Our job here is to beat BJ and Migs.
That's it.
Just so we can make fun of them in the hallway. That is it. And put a brand new coat on a kid in need. Please head to KISW.com and help us with Operation Warm. Okay, I'm sorry, Ted, continue.
No worries.
We have breaking news.
We have breaking news happening.
We even have breaking news music. I mean, that's, you know,
if
you're
we have
important.
More, I might interrupt you again. I don't know, and I apologize in advance.
Okay, no problem. Miles, everybody loves a dirty German, some Australian, but what is probably the best accent that gets done in this room? Or impression?
Impression?
Is it Scottish?
I don't know.
It
man.
Is not.
I like the finish of both Mickey and Captain Crunch.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. I love Nick Cage.
All right.
Is this a Nicolas Cage thing?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I had no idea this honor was coming my way.
I thought you were being serious. Like I was supposed to pick the one that's good.
I'm not, well, I don't
think. What are you talking about?
Honestly, that is my
favorite. You close your eyes, the best. Just Nick's next to you.
So Nicolas Cage is hosting a 6-episode series on Netflix.
Damn right I am.
Called The History of Swear Words.
Because Samuel Jackson wasn't available.
Funny enough, there'll be some celebrity guests. Samuel Jackson is not one of them, but Sarah Silverman will be one of them. Nikki Glaser, who's super funny. Nick Offerman. But it also includes Linguist. Yeah.
Her love language was covered in marinara.
Cognitive scientist and lexiconographers. Lexiconographers?
Lexiconographers?
Yeah.
Lexiconographers?
Thank you, Mike. That's
probably how you say it.
Right. But anyhow, here's a preview. He kind of spells it out for you, but see if you could guess the curse word he's talking about.
It is a thing of great wonder and mystery.
That sounds so subdued.
With complexity, strength, and resilience. However, also buried within a delicate femininity. And dare I even say, naughtiness. Look one way and you see a gentle feline innocence. Look another way and, oh my. Yes, it has the power to stir our souls and intoxicate our minds. Men have died for it. Women have moved in with each other way too soon for it. And to fully capture its essence, we must plunge, unafraid, deep within its enchanted garden. Oh, my friends, we are so close now. Feast your eyes upon the very house of life and death, the temple of sensuality. And a term for that kid too afraid to play dodgeball in gym class. Behold!
Euphemism for...
vagina!
Could also be a cat.
I think you're... It's closer than I thought it was.
Your impersonation
of Nick Cage. I really do.
Nick Cage, like...
Do you know the word I'm talking about?
And the other thing, too, is like, I mean, I heard this today.
The giver of life.
And I was like, God, he's so dramatic. And
it's like if the Predator were toothless.
Mm-hmm. I'm like, have you seen some Nick Cage movies?
Not a long time.
Recently. No.
So, like, leaving Las Vegas, he got a lot of credit.
You got an Academy Award for that one.
He did. Got nominated. He won.
He won it.
Which is tough.
Joke's on you.
Right. He was drunk half the time anyhow.
Right.
I didn't even know we were filming a movie.
But also, like, I liked, did you ever see Con Air?
Years ago.
Yeah, that was a pretty good movie.
Face Off, was he in that one too?
Yes.
Him and Travolta.
That's right.
And Gina Gershon.
Actually wore Travolta's face.
And in Raising Arizona, one of the best of all times.
Yeah, so Nick Cage, look, he's a whack job. That's just out there. Look,
he knows it.
Gone in 60 Seconds. I love that movie. I could watch it every time.
It was originally about my erection.
Oh. Well, you do a lot of drugs and drink a lot.
That's exactly why, Miles.
I don't know. I heard his voice today, and I was like, yeah, that's Nick Cage. Like, doing his Nick Cage. And I kind of forgot. Like, you know, we make fun of him all the time, but, like, you like him.
Yeah. No reason not to.
Didn't he get in a drunken fight with...
He tried to get Vince Neil off somebody.
Yeah.
Yeah, Vince Neil was going to eat somebody who did him dirty as he perceived it.
I just love...
And Nicolas Cage was the voice of reason. And anytime you're in a situation, and Nicolas Cage is the voice of reason, reevaluate your life choices.
They were at dinner, and somebody...
Calm down, Vince!
And somebody walked over or reached over, I can't remember the exact story, and stole one of his french fries. And Vince wanted to kill him.
I just like the... Like, I'm with you. I just like the idea of the Nick Cage. Like, can you imagine being in Vegas? I saw that video. And out stumbles Vince Neil, and the Nick Cage is calming him down. But they are both... wasted.
Oh,
and I don't mean like kind of drunk. Don't do it, man. You get in trouble. Which, also, look, you've been to as many bars as I've been to or tailgates. Like, you've seen this before.
Yeah.
Where it's like, man, I don't know how either of them are standing, but super drunk guy is right.
Plus, they're both residents of Vegas. They hang out all the time. They're close friends. They're just two guys going out to a bar. They just happen to live in Vegas.
Yeah, I still don't know if I could handle living in Vegas. But I think when you live there, it's a different animal. You're not going to the strip all the time or whatever.
You probably manage it somehow.
Yeah.
You have to.
I wouldn't.
I think it depends on who you are.
I'd be dead in 4 days.
Yep.
Did Elvis die there or did he die at home in Graceland?
I think he was at home.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Because he's rocking the toilet. The man died on the toilet.
He did. Yeah.
The throne. He is the king.
You're damn right. One thing I know, I like to watch people breakdance. It's always good to see.
I can watch people break dance.
Yeah,
that's a dance I can watch.
Sometimes it's just called breaking. That's what we say when we're trying to be cool, man.
When back in the day, were you a popper or a breaker?
I think technically when I tried, I was more of a breaker.
Okay.
All right.
But I was never very good at it. You know what I mean?
Like, you're a good dancer. I
what about you?
Pull it off. I was a popper. Steve does the same thing. Just do the robot, basically. It's kind of like a popper. Just, you know.
I remember the first time my mom showed me the robot. I thought it was the coolest thing. Granted, I was 7.
I watched a video of a dude the other day. He's got to be in his 70s. Just this old white dude. And I mean, he for like 6 minutes.
He's on a robot?
Absolutely crushing it. And not like, you know, like a lot of people just kind of go like that right. speed, but he's doing like the super quick, like, I was like, oh my God. Like, to the point of like nobody's laughing. Everybody's just like, this guy's the man.
Yeah. He's going to get laid tonight.
Yeah. He's going to sleep with the bride tonight if he's not related to her.
Damn.
I mean, it was that good. Well, now, breakdance is going to be an Olympic sport in 2024 in Paris.
Really?
That's Paris, for people that don't understand my accent.
I got you.
Well, look, I mean, I nailed that French name earlier, so.
We think you did.
Speaking a lot of French, well, I didn't see the French people calling in.
Mm-hmm. No.
Our buddy's married to a Frenchie. I'll try it on her tonight.
A Frenchie. I dig it.
When you speak the language, you can use those terms.
Oh, you're closer now, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's going to be an Olympic sport.
Yeah, it joins climbing, skateboarding, surfing, which all debut next summer at the Tokyo Games.
Good.
I mean, look.
I got no problem with that, man. Yeah. They got plenty of stuff that I have zero. And I grant, right. I understand it's the Olympics, but still, like, I will watch some of those.
I mean, half of the other stuff sounds made up anyway. I mean, not depending on the sport of the Olympics, but I mean, like, the biathlon. I'm cross-country skiing, and then I'm shooting stuff.
Yeah, like, I don't watch that. I don't know
anyone who does that.
Norway crushes that.
I bet they do. That's their lifestyle.
Right, and that's, like, the only sports they're good at are the Nordic sports.
Of course.
Yeah, but, Miles, I'm with you, right? I've seen a lot of people skiing. I've seen a lot of people hunting. I haven't seen anybody, go out on skis to go hunt something.
Anybody say, like, dude, I got to work on my discus work this weekend, man. It's just, it's just.
Oh, it's breaking news.
Breaking news.
Mike Hawk, what's going on over there as far as goes for Kids Day? How we doing?
We're a short $1,300 away from our goal for this hour.
For this hour.
For this
$1,300.
Hour.
$1,300. Okay, please head to KISW. Donate now. The final push is on for the men's room and coats for Kids Day, presented by the Advocates. Keep in mind, you can go anytime you get home tonight. Head to KISW.com. Remember, $20 puts a brand new coat on a child in need in Washington State. Back to you, Ted.
The International Olympic Committee is adding these types of sports to make fun summer games, quote, more gender balanced, more youthful, and more urban.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean,
you have to make it youthful. I mean, you don't see a lot of elderly people competing in the Olympics. You know, everyone there is already 18 to what, 24?
Yeah, I mean, the oldest players are probably going to be the professional hockey players or basketball players.
Right. But they're still playing.
Rifle team.
You know what? That's a good call. What's that? Marks? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, shooting stuff. Either way.
Stuff shooters.
do you guys remember Richard Crazy Legs Cologne?
No.
He's one of the early superstars of breakdance, and he says, quote, it goes beyond just the moves. The passion and the pain that goes with living through the struggle is the essence of the dance.
But the guy smells good.
You want to make sure the soul of it isn't diluted.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, look, right, breakdancing a lot of times comes from urban areas. You're talking cities. I mean, when I was a kid, I was obsessed with cardboard boxes. As I got older, I realized you flatten them out to shoot dice. But when I was a kid, like that would seem like the coolest people you ever saw were breakdancing on the street on a cardboard box. Speaking of cardboard boxes, like the Rams defense or offense? I don't know. I tried. The Rams are playing the Patriots tonight.
You're not going to watch all the Hanukkah specials they have aired? You're going to watch football?
I hold out for night 3.
Oh, gotcha. Good call.
That's the best night.
Thank you, Chad.
It's live.
We really appreciate that. You are listening to The Men's Room.
New on Curiosity Stream.
Just because it hasn't been done before doesn't mean you can't.
Watch Earth's greatest minds forge our path to a better tomorrow. It's Engineering the Future and Jaws, Star Wars, The Godfather, E.T. The biggest movies have even bigger music. From King Kong to The Dark Knight. See how musicians scored Hollywood's greatest hits on great film composers' music of the movies. Watch now on Curiosity Stream. Annual plans are $20, just $1.67 a month. Visit curiositystream.com.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. When we think about the COVID-19 vaccine hesitancy in the Black community, let's remember, it didn't happen by chance. It's justified in history. But the will to change the narrative is strong today, and our people are lending their voices to the conversation. We're sharing our stories and the reasons that made us choose the vaccine so we can lead the way for others to make a well-informed choice, too. To hear our stories, visit hearforus.wa.org.
Bro, gnarly.
What's up, Taylor?
Dude, that nerd in his electric hybrid totally blew the light while texting his yuppie friends.
That's so bogus, bro. Are you hurt?
Yeah, like I can't move my hips, bro. I think I broke my pelvis, man.
Dude, no way!
Wait!
Taylor, you need to drop a dime and talk with the lawyers at the Advocates Law Firm.
No way, can't afford that, bro.
Your crotch is broken, man, and they don't earn any money unless they win your case.
Dude, no way.
You get injured, the Advocates get results. Contact them today at advocateslaw.com.
Steve, I-90 and Rainier, collision blocking the right lane.
Talk with the Advocates.
U.S. 2 at Fur Road, another crash blocking all lanes.
Another example of why you should talk with Ken and creepy, creepy, creepy Kyle at the Advocates. Look, if you get injured, you want the Advocates on your side, fighting to make sure that you're fairly compensated for your injuries and losses.
That's right. Plus, it's gray and wet. That makes the roads less safe. So just be careful and hit up advocateslaw.com and see if they can help you.
And tell Kyle to blow his nose, because it sounds like a three-year-old with post-nasal drip.
Hey, I'm Mike, and this year, thanks to Metro, nothing's getting between me and my holidays. As a rideshare driver, I know a thing or two about going the extra mile, and Metro's helping me go even further. Metro covered the switching fees and gave me and the family high-speed data for only $25 a line for four lines. Plus, we scored four free Galaxy phones from Metro just for switching. Now, we can all get in the holiday spirit streaming our favorite tunes and ring in the new year over video chat with family and friends.
You work hard. Switching to Metro isn't. This season, there's zero fees to switch. And right now, enjoy Metro's lowest price. Just $25 a line for four lines. Plus four free Samsung Galaxy phones when you switch.
I'm Mike, and that's how I rule my holiday with Metro.
Plus device sales tax with eligible port in and no T-Mobile service in past 180 days. One phone per line while supplies last. If new line deactivates, all lines lose four line promo rate. Additional terms apply. Limited time offer. See Metro by T-Mobile.com.
Do you ever have FOMO or fear of missing out? Well, now's your chance to get ahead of it. The juicy, tangy McRib is back for a limited time at McDonald's. And I may or may not be the first in line to get one, or two, or three.
Free healthcare. Hundreds to more than $1,000 per month in disability compensation and tens of thousands for college tuition. These are just some of the U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs benefits that may be available to veterans. VA is focused on customer service like never before. Choose VA and see why veterans' trust in VA reached an all-time high. Claim the benefits you've earned at choose.va.gov.
Navy Federal, this is Michelle. How may I assist you today?
Michelle, we haven't talked since I got the Navy Federal app. With personalized notifications, I always know what's happening in my account. See, my paycheck just deposited.
I'm glad you like.
Sorry, just pay my bills.
When your members are the mission, so is their convenience. Set up notifications, check your balance, and track your spending with our mobile app. Navy Federal Credit Union. Our members are the mission. Insured by NCUA. Message and data rates apply.
You know, I still need to find the perfect gift for my girl, Jenny.
What does she like?
She loves going out, but isn't great with directions. And she loves music, but doesn't have the best sound system.
How about a new receiver from Car Toys? They've got Alpine, Kenwood, Pioneer, and Sony, with free installs starting at $249.
Oh, yeah, great idea. Can you drive? She's a stick.
Seriously? Let's go.
The Car Toys holiday sale is bigger than ever. Find great deals like half-off speakers from Alpine, Focal, and Pioneer. Don't wait. Shop in-store or online at CarToys.com.
Car Toys, a better way to go.
Celebrate the holiday spirit with treasured gifts from Pandora Jewelry. Find a holiday gift for the one in your heart. Rings and earrings with timeless sparkle or charms that keep her loved ones close. Exquisitely crafted holiday gift sets starting at $99. Shop Pandora Jewelry today for the perfect holiday gift that captures the magic of the season. Gift sets available while supplies last. See store for details.
Visit the Pandora store at Bellevue Square and all major malls.
Hey, Washington. GEICO won best customer satisfaction among auto insurers in the Northwest region, according to J.D. Power. And GEICO was ranked best in price, so switching to GEICO is a good decision. Unlike the decision to improvise your best man speech.
Okay. I didn't actually write anything, but I love you, brother. Remember when you were just a baby, right? And you would cry, like, all day. And you couldn't even talk.
GEICO, a decision you can feel good about. For J.D. Power 2020 award information, visit geico.com/JD Power.
If you've got an insurance question, you could talk to the butcher at your local grocery store. He'd probably talk about trimming the fat, but it'd be about your brisket, not your insurance policies. Or you could talk to your local GEICO agent. They offer personalized assistance in finding the choicest cuts of coverage for all your insurance needs, which means more money for filet mignon, or if you're a vegetarian, tofu le mignon. To find a GEICO agent near you, visit geico.com/local.
Sometimes in business, the unexpected comes calling. From rent increases to increased orders to, I'm going to say it, unprecedented times. But don't bounce back. Bounce forward with Comcast Business. Bounce forward fast with internet speeds up to a gig, with the flexibility to update your bandwidth in just a few clicks, and with security solutions that help keep your connected devices protected. Be fast, be flexible, be ready for what's next. Help your business bounce forward with this amazing offer. Get a powerful and reliable internet and voice solution starting at just $64.90 a month for 12 months for 2 years. Ask how to get a $500 prepaid card when you upgrade. Call 1-800-501-6000 or go to ComcastBusiness.com today to learn more. Prepaid card offer ends 12/21/20. Restrictions apply. New customers only with 25 megabits per second service and one voice line. Early termination fee applies. Equipment, installation, taxes, and fees extra and subject to change. Call for details.
What's in store this holiday at Staples?
Gifts and packages shipped with care.
So you can relax knowing they'll soon be there.
Now at Staples, save 25% on UPS expedited shipping services.
Plus, take up to 30% off select shipping supplies like boxes, tape, and padded mailers.
Shop in store or get it same day with Instacart.
And save on holiday shipping at Staples.
In store only. Offers end 1/2/21. See store for details. Instacart not available on shipping services. Fees, taxes, additional terms, and or tips may apply. Delivery subject to availability.
You're ready to get back into yoga, so you order the essentials. A non-slip mat, yoga blocks to keep balance, and an exercise ball. And you use your Bank of America Cash Rewards credit card, choosing to earn 3% cash back on online shopping and up to 5.25% as a preferred rewards member, which you put towards your most essential yoga gear. Noise-canceling headphones.
Welcome. Take a deep breath.
Apply for yours at bankofamerica.com/more rewarding. Copyright 2020 Bank of America Corporation.
The Men's Room on the Rock, powered by the Advocates, official sponsor of the Men's Room. The last thing anyone expects is to be injured in a car crash. That's why you want the Advocates on your side. Don't get lowballed and taken advantage of by the insurance companies. Call the Advocates today, 206-512-3555 or advocateslaw.com.
You're in the Men's Room. Text the guys at 77999. 99.9 KISW.
We are so close. So close to hitting the $5,700 goal this hour. Please head to KISW.com. Give whatever you can. And it's Coats for Kids Day. The idea, $20 puts a brand new coat on a Washington State child who needs one. BJ Shea coming up. And Mike Hawk with headlines. You are listening to the Men's Room.
Yeah.
returns with Miles and Thrill. Now, let's see what's happening in the real world.
All right, here we go. As we head to Connecticut, where a mall Santa faces felony charges after whipping out his red-nosed reindeer. Meanwhile, a woman is mad at a maintenance man. After getting a new toilet, a brown streak did appear, and it was not hers. Minnesota Dairy Queen customer starts a pay-it-forward chain that included 900 cars. English gardener finds $19,000 in gold coins buried in his backyard in jars. An Arizona woman evicted from her home does the only logical thing and burns the place down. It is time for your headline.
Now, it's time to hit the head. Lines. Here's my cock.
All right. So we're not doing headlines today, but we will be giving it one final push. We got a couple minutes left here before we get to the top of the hour. I'm sorry, Ted. I'm throwing off my rhythm over
focus,
here.
Focus, man.
I'm focusing. We got 2 minutes left. Due to time constraints, we can't take it all the way up to that all 6 right. o'clock, but I know that the people can make it. So I'm asking everybody to give it one final push, one final donation. Again, every dollar counts. Share it on every social media page that you have. Get everybody else to help out in this thing. We're trying to just make that $5,700 goal for this hour, and we need your help. We're going to give it down to the final 60 seconds. I understand that we have our own BJ Shea on the line. We'll have him on in just a few minutes, hopefully listening to us drink some delicious blended concoctions up here. Okay, giving it a refresh here. Let's see, 60 seconds to go. Ladies and gentlemen, jump in there again. Every dollar. If it's a dollar, if it's two, three, four, or seven.
Ooh, the auctioneer's coming out.
That's right. The auctioneer's coming out on this one. Yeah. $2, five, seven and a half, 10, 12 and a half, 15, 17 and a half, 20, 22 and a half, 25. I don't care what it is. Jump on in there. We need your help. We need every last dollar.
Come on.
We're down to the final 40 seconds. If anybody can jump in there and donate one more dollar, I'd sure appreciate it because I haven't drinking a thing all day and quite frankly, I'm exhausted. I need energy, man. I need carbs. I need something. I'm losing
it
over here.
Careful what you wish for.
Do I know, man. Miles is over there. He's practically losing his hair. He needs a little something to drink. Over
I'm thirsty. I'm so thirsty.
It's falling out of his head. Nah, Mr. Hill hasn't had a good helping of veggies in ever. So now we need to get him a green smoothie in there. We're down to the final 10 seconds before I hit this refresh button for one final time.
Okay, should we go to BJ Shea from the BJ and Migs show there?
Do we have him on the line?
We do. BJ, are you there?
Hello.
BJ Shea, what's happening?
Hello, but what's happening is I am enjoying listening and watching you guys drink the nastiest stuff on the planet.
Yeah. You guys had a hell of a morning, man. Congratulations.
Yeah, man.
Hats
great
off.
Work.
That was unbelievable.
Thanks, man. Well, you guys know this. The Rockaholics are amazing. I mean, you know, we get credit for it, but they're the ones that gave the money.
Oh, no, absolutely, man. They've been stepping up all day, all afternoon. Hopefully we can get a couple more donations into the evening with Taryn. But, yeah, this has been a great day. I know you guys initially started out. What did you say, BJ, that you're thinking about hitting about $10,000?
Yeah, because I think what we needed to get to 35. We thought, man, we want to get it to 35,000 because that's what they wanted. You know, the Operation Warm folks wanted that. And so we thought if we can do about 10 on our show, that would be good.
Okay. Well, you guys way surpassed that. $22,811. Yeah. Did you even recognize the Reverend Infuego after he shaved off his beard? Was that kind of weird to look at that guy and go, that's who's been under there all these years?
Oh, it was. I told everybody it's like that old Christmas show, Santa Claus is Coming to Town. He looks like that snowman that sings songs.
Well, you were, in fact, the snowman that sang songs this morning. How were the reviews on your singing skills?
Well, you know what? People were really kind, and they said I didn't do too badly, but I sang a song that
they're
I
liars. BJ, they are liars. That was horrendous.
Thank you, my friend, because I felt like it was. You know, I haven't heard anybody call me and ask me to be their new lead singer, so I think you may be more right about that.
Oh, BJ, we have breaking news. We have an updated total on Coats for Kids Day. What do we got there, Mike?
Okay, our goal was $5,700. Together, you all pulled together in this final hour. We raised $6,468.
All right! Here we go!
Which means it's time for me to blend up.
Great way to finish. That is awesome. Thank you so much, Rockaholics. That is a big deal. We got some drinking to do, man.
So help me with this one more time, Miles. What all needs to go into this thing?
Oh, my
olives.
God. It needs
egg
to be.
Egg salad.
Yeah.
There you go. Get that egg in there.
Corn dog, chips, barbecue sauce, and a Coke.
Yes. Do you got everything?
Yes. We need a corn dog, too.
On it.
Yeah. Tell you what, BJ. Yeah. We'll keep a little of this and put it in the fridge for you. You can sip some tomorrow.
Do not, BJ, seriously. You know there's a green thing in there, all right? Veggie Dog made it. It's one of his smoothies. Whatever you do, do not accidentally drink that tomorrow morning.
Speaking of which.
You will be on the toilet every single break. Oh, my God, and they're passing it on to Steve and Thrill Hill.
We will go live on Facebook here momentarily to watch him drink that one.
All right, BJ, congratulations to you. Congratulations to Migs, everybody on the show. You guys did an amazing job today. We were not up to the challenge. We did the best job we could, but you guys just blew it out of the water this morning, man, and we did the best we possibly could. But either way, it's all for a great cause. All the Rockaholics stepped up today. So, man, congratulations. Hats off.
Six more grand. You're right. Yeah. I mean, that's fantastic. I mean, thank you.
Right. And a lot of people don't know this. We had a side bet. If BJ and Migs won, they would be willing to do our afternoon show on Friday.
For a month. And we fought, really? Man, yeah, oh, man. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That is cool.
What a deal.
Also,
a
Miles, deal. Good news.
What's
the core dog is ice cold.
Oh, Jesus, God. This is a good
there
deal.
Goes the olives. Yeah, BJ, I got to tell you, I know you hate that song, but Dominic the Donkey might be my new favorite Christmas song, dude.
Uh-huh.
Ted, you used to be my friend.
Wow. I didn't know this was the tipping point.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, here come the...
This was it. All right, all right.
Here come the potato chips. BJ, again, congratulations to you, man. That is a fantastic day. If you can, by the time you get home, and you haven't done so, $20 puts a brand new coat on a Washington State child in need. Head to KISW.com. We want to thank our good friends at The Advocates for being a huge part of all this. Please head to KISW.com. We are about to drink the barbecue blend, egg salad, chips, olives, corn dogs, barbecue sauce, and Coke, while our own Steve the Thrill Hill drinks some kind of disgusting-looking vegetable mixture.
Have you smelled this?
I don't want to smell it. Remember how you said don't smell stuff? Why are you smelling it?
It looks like something you scrape off of a pond when spring shows up. Mm-hmm. It really does.
Exactly. Exactly.
All right, BJ. Hey, man, thank you, brother.
Yep, we appreciate it.
My pleasure, boys.
All right, congratulations once again. BJ and Migs, $22,811. Tomorrow morning, by the way, they should have an updated total on everything that we raised on Coats for Kids Day to give us a pretty good idea how we did. Right now, some of the things... Jesus.
That is the sound of the blender.
Right now, totals are still coming in, so we won't have a final count for you tomorrow morning, but be sure to tune in and congratulate those guys on the win.
Yeah, for sure, man. For
sure. On everything they did for Coats for Kids. Thank you, Washington State Council of Firefighters. Thank you, Operation Warm. This has been a hell of a day, man, and we are going to leave with some serious heartburn and probably throw up before we get home. Yeah, it's going to be a good time.
Right. And the thing I'm drinking is something that a dude we work with drinks every day.
Mm-hmm. Okay, all right.
You ready for this, Miles?
I'm not ready for this.
No, you're not.
No. I do not want any of
this. Oh, yeah,
dude.
Jesus. Hey. That looks worse than mine, Miles.
Let's just let's put the video up if you happen to like KISW on Facebook, and you can see if we throw up or not before we drink this final concoction. All right, we're out of here. Hey, thank you so much. We appreciate it. Coats for Kids was a huge success. Again, BJ and Migs will have the totals for you tomorrow. Arukata, happy Hanukkah, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow.
You can watch them drink it live on Facebook right now.
Oh, yes, you can. But in the meantime, we almost be all about this bitch. We will be back tomorrow. Until then, please do what you do best, and you did good today. And for Aletha's sake, stay beautiful.
The Men's Room has been taped before a live studio audience. Wardrobe and makeup provided by Mantastic Limited. This has been a presentation of the Men's Room Radio Network.
Oh, man!
A Double Flush production.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. When we think about the COVID-19 vaccine hesitancy in the Black community, let's remember, it didn't happen by chance. It's justified in history. But the will to change the narrative is strong today, and our people are lending their voices to the conversation. We're sharing our stories and the reasons that made us choose the vaccine so we can lead the way for others to make a well-informed choice, too. To hear our stories, visit hearforuswa.org.
In the wee hours of the night, when everyone else is fast asleep, you're the one on third shift, burning the midnight oil. When a part fails and everything comes to a grinding halt, regardless of what the clock on the wall says, you leap into action. Grainger is with you and all the ones who get it done. With 24/7 customer support by phone or click to chat. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.